So Microsoft just recently released an update that's actually breaking Word, Excel, and Outlook on users' machines. So I want to tell you a little bit about it and kind of explain what you can do to fix it. But this is an example for those of you that are kind of in this channel, watching this channel to learn cybersecurity, some of the things that we see pretty frequently on the job. Okay, so this is the update 572700, and this was released, you see right here, on April 8th, so last week. Essentially, what happens is we typically put a delay in before we deploy these patches to users' machines. But once again, sometimes there's things that Microsoft releases that has issues that don't necessarily make the news. And so what happens is a lot of times these updates come out and they break stuff, and it's not enough stuff that's broken for it to make the headlines, and it just kind of stays under the radar. So essentially what we saw is on April the 8th, they released these updates, which is April 8th. That's going to be, I think this patch Tuesday. Let me confirm that. But anyway, once they release those updates, yes, that's correct. So on patch Tuesday, they released those updates. We have a 2-day delay to make sure that customers don't get these updates immediately, because we don't want to break it. But even with the 2-day delay, we got users that called in like first thing Friday morning saying, hey, when people launch Word, it won't open, or my Outlook won't open, or my Word, when I launch it, it gives an error and crashes. So just kind of like all over the place, but all related to Office. And we look on a user's machine and we can see that we deployed that update on Friday. So as a result, we start digging, and then just happened to find here, when I scroll down in the article, where is it? Right up, oh, I passed it. Known issues, okay? Now, the thing is, it says known issues, Microsoft Word, Excel, and Outlook might stop responding. That's pretty significant, because most people use Word, Excel, and Outlook for some reason, right? And so after installing KB2700, the issue is fixed in April update that was released on the 10th. So they released this 2 days later, which is Thursday. And this is update right here, KB5002600. Okay. So this fixes the issue. So of course we had to test this and stuff like that, and we were able to isolate it and roll out and test this on some of the affected users, because we didn't have any users affected in our org. And it did indeed resolve the problem by installing this update. But I want to make sure you know that you have to have 57, like basically you got to have both. So 52700, and then you go back and install 52623, and that resolves the issue. Oh, and it even gets better, because this update, even though they broke it, is not something that they automatically deploy. So what you have to do is you have to go to the download center here, and you have to download the update and deploy it. And it gets better. So if we click download here, you can see that this is also, but like, it's delivered as an exe file, right, for both of these. So it's not, you know, the thing is, for if you work in cybersecurity, an MSI file is very useful, because most of your software, you can just take it, upload the MSI, it will automatically find the information it needs inside the MSI file, which is basically the Microsoft installer file. So instead of, for those of you that are new to cybersecurity, you have .exes and you have .msis. They both are used to install software, but MSIs have additional information. So we have software where we can install this to thousands of machines. And so when you put it in, you upload it to whatever program we're going to use to do a mass deployment, it automatically will be able to read and know what the installation commands are, and will fill that in automatically. If you have an .exe file, that means we have to figure out how to install the software silently. So there's like little additional information you have to put on the command to install it, to make it install silent. It's not hard, but it's just something else we had to do. And so something to note too, that on your machines, you sometimes will have it's asking you, do you want an X64 or X86? So let me explain, like on your computer, you have like in a C colon program files. Let me see if I can bring this up for you and show you what I'm talking about, because sometimes in C, you'll have C colon program files and C colon program files X86, okay? So basically it's saying, okay, one is related to a 32-bit architecture, one is related to a 64-bit architecture, okay? Don't want to get too far in the weeds there. But the thing is, when you go to deploy this, what you'll find is in most cases, you're going to have to use this X86 file instead of this X64 file when you do the installation. So that's just something to note. So, but anyway, if you have any questions about this, if you were impacted, I would love to hear, like, just kind of see how widespread this was. So leave those comments in the comment of the video, and I'd love to respond. And I am responding to comments regularly now. So thanks for everybody that's been leaving comments. And if you made it to the end of the video, please put KB52623 in the comments. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video.